Hello, welcome to class 12 business studies, staffing, chapter 6, explanation,
part 2. And in this, we will be covering the following contents. They are staffing as part of human resource management, 2. Evolutions of human resource management and staffing process.
Now, let us start with the staffing as a part of human resource management. Means, human resource management is that part of general management which is specifically concerned with the human resources in an organization. Because without human resources, non-human resources like raw materials, machines, money, etc., they all remain idle. So, to activate all those non-human resources, the use of human resources are essentials. Because if no human beings are there, then obviously they'll not be able to utilize those non-human resources. So that is why staffing plays a very important role in an organization. So it is the functions where all the managers, they need to perform. So every managers, they need to perform it very well. So it is the job of the managers to fill all the positions in their organizations to make sure that the position remains occupied with qualified people. So as we all know that staffings, they are very closely linked to the organizations, since like all the structures and the positions have been decided where people are required to work in the given positions. So subsequently, they need to be well trained and should also be motivated to work in harmony and honesty with the goals of the organizations. So staffing is seen as a generic functions of management. So managing the human components of an organization are the most important task, because the performance of the organizations, they mainly depend on how well these functions are performed by the staffs. So the success of any organizations in achieving its success or its goal are mainly determined to the great extent on the motivations and performance of the human resources. Okay, so it's the responsibility of all the managers to directly deal with the staffs and also to select people to work for the organizations. So as the organization grows, a number of person employed also increases. So that is why there is a separate department called the human resource department, so which are formed like those who have the specialist in managing the people. So the management of human resources is a specialized area which requires the experts of many people. So the number of human resources specialist and size of the department also gives an indications of the size of the business as well. So for a very big or a large companies, the human resources development itself will contain the specialist for each functions of this department. Okay, so you can also say human resource management may be defined as the art of procuring, developing, and maintaining competent workforce to achieve the organizational goals efficiently. So human resource management aims at relating the people at work with the activities necessary to achieve the organizational goals. So that is why human resource management includes many specialized activities and duties with the human resource personnel which they must perform. So the duties of the human resources, or you can also say the functions of human resource personnel or managers or the department, their duties are to likewise their duties are as follows: recruitment, that is searching for a qualified people. Another one is analyzing jobs, means collecting the informations about the job to prepare the job descriptions. Another one is developing compensations and incentives plans. Another one is giving them a training and development of employees for efficient performance and career growth. Another one is maintaining labor relations and union management relations. Another one is handling grievances and complaints. 7. Providing for social security and welfare of employees. And the last is the 8 points: defending the company in lawsuits and avoiding legal complications. So all these are mentioned in your book as well. You can refer it. So these are the duties of the human resources management. That is the, these are the roles played by the Department of Human Resources. So these were the relation between explanation is related to the staffing as part of human resources management. And the next is the evolutions of human resource management. For this I will be showing you a video on the explanations of the evolutions of human resource management. Please go through the video very carefully.
देखिए, एक ज़माना ऐसा हुआ करता था कि इंसान इंसान की हालत में नहीं था. पहले वो पता नहीं कोई जानवर था, फिर इवॉल्व हुआ, फिर कुछ और बना, फिर कुछ और बना. बहुत भारी भरकम वर्ड्स होते हैं, साइंस में पढ़ाए गए थे बट मुझे बिल्कुल भी याद नहीं है. बट जो भी बनता गया, फाइनली इंसान इंसान की पोजिशन में आ गया. तो इसी तरह से HRM का भी इवोल्यूशन हुआ है. पहले ये HRM नहीं था, पहले ये किसी और नाम से जाना जाता था, बहुत ही बेसिक नेचर का कुछ काम करता था. उसके बाद फीचर्स बढ़े, नेचर बढ़ा, फंक्शंस बढ़े, नाम बढ़ा, एंड लास्टली और नाम बढ़ा, और काम बढ़ा, और फंक्शंस बढ़े. तो ऐसे कैसे इवॉल्व हुआ अलग अलग उसमें, वो हम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं इस वीडियो में. इट सेज कि सबसे पहले HRM, जो आज की डेट में HRM कहलाया जाता है, मतलब ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर कहलाया जाता है, उसे सबसे पहले हम लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर का नाम दिया करते थे. मतलब ये उसका फर्स्ट नेम है जो उसे पहले दिया गया था, लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर. एक ऐसा ऑफिसर जो लेबर के वेलफेयर के बारे में सोचता है. ये हुआ करता था लिंक बिटवीन ऑनर्स एंड वर्कर्स. ये बोलते हैं कि वर्कर्स और ऑनर्स आपस में बात नहीं कर पा रहे थे, तो उन्हें ना कोई इंटरमीडिएटरी चाहिए था, कोई बीच का इंसान चाहिए था जो दोनों के बीच में लिंक बने. तो वो बना ये इंसान, लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर. मतलब ऑनर्स और लेबर के बीच में, वर्कर्स के बीच में एक लिंक, एक ब्रिज की तरह इसने काम किया. इनकी बात उनको बताता, उनको समझाता, उनकी बात समझ के इनको समझाता, और इस तरह से स्मूथली पूरे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को चलाने का काम कर रहा था. लेकिन फिर हमने बोला सिर्फ इतना सा काम करने से बात नहीं बनेगी, आपको थोड़ा और काम करना पड़ेगा. तो आहिस्ता आहिस्ता जब काम बढ़ा, ड्यूटीज़ बढ़ी, फंक्शंस बढ़े, तो नाम भी थोड़ा बढ़िया होना चाहिए ना, लेबर वेलफेयर थोड़ा सस्ता टाइप साउंड कर रहा था, तो इन्होंने बोला कुछ बढ़िया सा नाम रखो, महंगा सा, शेड्स टाइप। तो इन्होंने बोला पर्सनल ऑफिसर रख दो, थोड़ा भारी भरकम लगता ना, और थोड़ा ऐसा लगता है क्लासी नेम है, तो इन्होंने बोला ये नाम रख दो। अब ये क्या करता है, ये रिक्रूटमेंट करता है, ये सिलेक्शन करता है, ये प्लेसमेंट करता है, मतलब ये लिंक तो पहले था ही था, उसके साथ साथ इसने रिक्रूटमेंट, प्लेसमेंट, सिलेक्शन ये सब भी स्टार्ट कर दिया। चलिए बढ़िया, फंक्शंस बढ़ गए हैं इसके, बहुत बढ़िया। उसके बाद इन्होंने बोला कि अब आ जाते हैं हम और क्लासी नाम पे, अब हम आ जाते हैं और बढ़िया एक नाम पे, तो इन्होंने नाम रखा ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर। मतलब आज जो नाम जिससे इसे बुलाया जाता है वो नाम इसका ऐसे ही नहीं पड़ गया, ओवर द टाइम अलग अलग नाम, अलग अलग फंक्शन करने के बाद इसे फाइनली एक नाम मिला जो कि है ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर। जैसे घर में बच्चा पैदा होता है तो बच्चा पैदा होते से ही उसको कोई नाम नहीं दे देते, लेकिन जब बच्चा पैदा होता है तो उसे बोलते हैं ओ सोना मोना बच्चा, ये वो प्यारा, ये वो, ठीक है। फिर थोड़े देर दिनों का और होता है तो हर घर वाला अपना अपना कोई नाम दे देता है, कोई मुन्ना, कोई छोटू, कोई प्यारू, क्या ये वो, कुछ ना कुछ नाम दे देगा। तो पहले कुछ रैंडम नेम्स बहुत ही प्यार वाले, उसके बाद सबके अपने अलग अलग नेम्स, और फाइनली उसे नामकरण पे एक नाम मिलता है। यहाँ पे वही हुआ है, यहाँ पे बच्चा पैदा हुआ है तो उसका नाम रखा है लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर, यहाँ उसे पर्सनल मैनेजर के नाम से जाना जा रहा है, और फिर फाइनली उसका नामकरण हुआ है और ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर उसे नाम मिला है। सो यहाँ इस तरह से पूरा एवोल्यूशन हुआ है ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट का। चलिए आगे की स्लाइड्स में हम थोड़ा सा पढ़ भी लेते हैं इसके बारे में। Human resource management has replaced the traditional concept of labor welfare and personal management. ये बोलते हैं human resource manager जब आया, obviously जब इंसान आया तो हमारे पुरानी वाली प्रजातियाँ वाली सारी गायब हो गई ना। अब आपको वो बंदर जैसा और वो सब मिलता है क्या? नहीं मिलता ना। अब क्योंकि हम इवॉल्व होके इस पोजिशन पर आ गए हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट ने रिप्लेस कर दिया है पुराने वाले दोनों लोगों को। ये जो दोनों लोग आपको दिखाई दे रहे हैं इनको उड़ा दिया है इसने, किसने? ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर ने। ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इन इट्स प्रेजेंट फॉर्म हैज इवॉल्व्ड फ्रॉम अ नंबर ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंट इंटर रिलेटेड डेवलपमेंट्स। ये बता रहे हैं कि भैया ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एक दिन में पैदा नहीं हो गया था, उसने इवोल्यूशन किया है, और मतलब बहुत ही सारी पीढ़ियों को देखने के बाद आया है कहीं। देन Emergence of trade union movement led to the need of a person who could act as an effective link between the owners and workers. ये बोलते हैं कि जब ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट्स का इमर्जेंस हुआ तो उस टाइम पे ना हमें एक ऐसे इंसान की रिक्वायरमेंट थी जो कि लिंक बन सके। मतलब एक ज़माना हुआ करता था जब ऐसा कोई भी इंसान नहीं था, जैसे हमने लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर के बारे में पढ़ा, ऐसा कोई इंसान नहीं था। लेकिन जैसे जैसे ट्रेड यूनियन की मूवमेंट्स बढ़ती गई ना तो हमें उस इंसान की कमी खलने लगी। और वो बोलते हैं ना, आवश्यकता ही आविष्कार की जननी है। तो मतलब हमें ज़रूरत पड़ी और हमने एक पोस्ट क्रिएट कर दी। किसकी करी? लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर की करी। सो लेबर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर आया और उसके बाद हिज रोल वॉज लिमिटेड टू बेयर मिनिमम वेलफेयर एक्टिविटीज ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज। जब ये स्टार्टिंग में आया था इसके बहुत कम काम थे, मैंने आपको बताया था स्टार्टिंग में फंक्शंस बहुत कम थे, ओवर द टाइम फंक्शंस ऐड हुए हैं, तो इसके स्टार्टिंग में फंक्शंस बहुत कम थे। इनफैक्ट ही वॉज लुक्ड डाउन बाय बोथ द वर्कर्स एंड द ओनर्स। इवन कई बार तो इसको ना इधर से भी गाली सुनने को मिलती थी, उधर से भी, मतलब ना उनकी बात ये मतलब ना वर्कर्स इनकी बात सुनते थे ना ही ओनर्स इनकी बात सुनते थे। ऐसा भी जमाना था। और आज एक ज़माना देखिए कि एचआर की पूजा होती है किसी भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में, मतलब कायदे से देखा जाए तो नॉट लिटरल पूजा होती है लेकिन बहुत अहमियत मिलती है। विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फैक्ट्री सिस्टम थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पर्सन बिगेन टू बी एम्प्लॉयड अंडर वन रूफ। जब फैक्ट्री सिस्टम आया तो एक एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में हज़ार हज़ार लोग काम करने लगे। भैया पहले ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी कम होती थी, लोग काम करने वाले भी कम होते थे। जैसे जैसे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ग्रो करी वैसे वैसे लोग भी ग्रो करने लगे, लोग भी ज़्यादा ज़्यादा आने लग गए। तो अब हमें और फंक्शंस ऐड करने थे, और फंक्शंस ऐड करने थे, तो हमने पर्सनल ऑफिसर को ले आए एग्जिस्टेंस में। मतलब पहले मैं चलिए लास्ट में रिवाइज कराऊंगी, पर्सनल ऑफिसर को ले आए, फिर उसके बाद और आहिस्ता आहिस्ता फास्ट पेस चेंजिंग टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट्स ने नए स्किल्स और डेवलपमेंट ये सब सिखाया, और उसके बाद फाइनली हमें एचआर की रिक्वायरमेंट फील हुई.
सो दिस वाज एन एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑन अ शॉर्ट वीडियो ऑफ एवोल्यूशंस ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. होप इट वाज क्लियर फॉर यू ऑल. एंड द नेक्स्ट इज स्टाफिंग process. Under this we will be discussing on the 8 points of the process. The first one is estimating the manpower recruitment, 2 recruitment, 3 selection, 4 placement and orientation, 5 training and development, 6 performance appraisal, 7 promotion and career, and the last is the 8th point is the compensation. So now let us go in detail. The first one is estimating the manpower recruitment, means it is the first thing in the planning process is to estimate manpower needs, means an effort is made to assess manpower needs in advance, keeping in view the production schedules, demand forecast, market schedules, etc. Or you can also say it means finding out the number and types of employees which are needed by the organizations in the near future. So the requirement of the manpower is not only to find out the number of people needed but also the type of people. So it aims to determine the number and types of employees required. So the types here refers to the specific qualification, educational background of the people whom we need to appoint. While assessing the type of manpower which are required by the company, should also make policy regarding the number of people to be appointed from backward classes, women force, minority, etc. And also who has a skill or experience to be possessed by the employees. So the manpower requirements involved two kinds of analysis. So they are workload analysis and workforce analysis. So workload analysis means it requires finding the number and type of employees is required to perform various jobs designed in organizational structure. And the workforce analysis means analyzing the existing workforce or employees which are already occupied or which are already occupying the job positions, and like to see how many of them are overburdened or underburdened, because overstaffing leads to lesser work. Next is the recruitment. So recruitment means it refers to the process of finding possible candidate for a job or a functions, or you can also say it refers to the process of inducing the people to apply for the job in an organization. So it has been defined as the process of searching for a prospective employees and stimulating them to apply for jobs in an organization, so that the organizations can get more choice and select better. After assessing the number and types of employees required, the manager tries that more and more people should apply for the job so that the organizations can get, like I told you, more choices and select the best of the best candidates. And the third point is selections. So as we all know, what does a selection means? It is the process of identifying and choosing the best of the best person out of a number of a prospective candidates for a job. So selection process serves two important purposes. They are, it ensures that the organization gets the best among the available options, and second is, it enhances the self-esteem and also the prestige of those selected candidates, and to make them realize the seriousness with which the things are done in an organization. The fourth is the placement and orientations. Means this process is mainly concerned with the socializations of the employees at the workplace. So it is the process of familiarizing the employees with a new working environment. Obviously, we must make them familiar with the new working environment. The employees are familiarized with his superior and subordinates and his colleagues as well. So orientation is introducing the selected employee to other employees and familiarizing him with the rules and regulations, the policies of an organization. So I hope you know what does the orientation means. Orientation means introducing the selected employees to the other employees and making him familiar about the rules, the regulations, the policies of the organizations, whereas placement refers to the assigning of specific jobs to the candidates. So selected for appointments. After selections, the employees are given the appointment letter and is asked to occupy the vacant job positions. Clear? And the fifth one is training and development. So this step involves the improving the job knowledge by giving them a proper training and competence of the employees by the help of the development in order to enable them to perform their job efficiently and very effectively. So if you need if you want to see the development in them, if you want to see them improving, so more training and developments are needed. So training helps in the process of increasing their knowledges, skills and abilities of the employees for doing a particular job. And development refers to the learning of opportunities designed to help the employees grow. So as we know, in most of the organizations there is a separate human resource department, so which takes care of staffing functions, but in case of small organizations, the line manager is required like to perform all the functions of managers. So the process of staffing will then include three more stages. Clear? So the sixth is performance appraisal. So after the employees they have undergone a period of like training and they have been doing on the job for some times, and so there is a need to evaluate their performance. We need to see the work done by them. So performance appraisal means evaluating an employee's current and or past performance as against certain predetermined standards to see their, to evaluate means to collect the informations about his current and past performance. So the employees are expected to know what the standards are, and the superior is to provide the employees feedback on his or her performance, like how we get the performance certificate after we finish our schooling. So same as that. So the superior is to provide the employees with a feedback on his or her performance. So the performance appraisal process therefore will include defining the job, appraising the performance, and providing the feedbacks. The seventh point is the promotion and career planning. So in this, promotion refers to being placed at a higher job positions, like which leads to more pay, more prestige, more respect, job satisfactions, and also you'll have a higher you like higher the job, higher the responsibilities. So promotion refers to being placed at a higher job positions with more of pay, job satisfactions, and more of responsibilities. So it becomes necessary for all the organizations to address career related issues and promotional avenues for their employees. So promotion also leads to the motivations to the new employees in an organization. So the manager needs to design the activities to serve the employees' long-term interest also. And they must encourage employees to grow and realize their full potential. Now we have come to the last point, that is the eighth point. Under this is the compensations. So compensations, it refers to all forms of pays or rewards going to the employees. So it may be in the form of a direct financial payments like wages, salaries, incentives, commissions, and bonus, and indirect payments like employer paid insurance and vacations, etc. So the direct financial payments are of two types. They are time based and performance based. So time based means like a time based plan means salary and wages are paid either daily, weekly, or monthly, or annually. And performance based plan means salary or wages are paid according to piece work. So with this, we have completed.